to another episode of Proverbs A Day Keeps the Enemy Away. Hello boys and girls, praise be to God. Well, here we are to learn some truths from the 9th chapter of the book of Proverbs, specifically verse 10. Wisdom is given a very prominent role here as in most of the chapters in Proverbs. Wisdom is here personified as having human qualities. None of us like to be told what to do. We all like to be independent, even small children. But we have to listen to the wisdom of elders, parents, and teachers, especially as they are more well-versed in the scriptures. We all say we love God, but how do we know and show that we love God? By obeying His commands. Now, verse 9 says, "Instruct a wise man and he will be wiser still. Teach a righteous man and he will add to his learning." When we use the word wise here, it doesn't refer to someone very intelligent like a genius who is a scientist or someone very clever in the class. Wisdom in the Bible, it refers to skill for living. So a wise man will pay attention to God's words and others who instruct him without being offended, wanting to grow. Children, you go to school and Sunday school and you learn a lot of things, but that doesn't alone make you wise. You have to listen to the instructions of your teachers, otherwise you go in the wrong path. If a lifeguard tells you not to swim in a dangerous portion of the sea, will you do it? No, but you might and you end up being drowned. In the same way, your parents tell you not to play with fire in the kitchen or in some other place. Will you do it? No, but you might and you'll end up getting burned. So wisdom is the discernment to know what is right and what is wrong. Now verse 10 is the most important verse in this chapter. The first part goes like this: "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom." Now where does this wisdom come from? Where is the source? It is God Almighty. Now here, when we mention fear, it doesn't mean fear of spiders or snakes or something horrific like that. It means reverence and respect for the one who is all powerful, that is our God Almighty. He is omnipotent. If you fear the Lord, you will keep His commands, including listening to your parents, as mentioned in Ephesians chapter 6. And this is the beginning of wisdom. You'll start becoming wise. You think you'll become wise when you go through the internet and browse through all sorts of sites. But that doesn't make you wise. It is just information. You have to know to discern. You have to know how to filter the information that you get. So children, remember, God gives wisdom to make important decisions, to direct our steps each day, to meet life's challenges, and to live in a different manner in this wicked world. Getting wisdom is also the ability to acquire the truth about God and His will and His grace and the good news concerning Jesus Christ and the gift of salvation. The enemy tries to make you do a lot of unspiritual things, but with wisdom, you can tell him no. You can even say no to your friends who tell you to do the wrong things, and you can resist all kinds of temptation. The second part of verse 10 goes like this: "The knowledge of the Holy One is understanding." Who is the Holy One? Our Lord, the God Almighty. Now, you say you know God, but how much do you know about God? How much do you know about His character, His nature? You say you know some celebrity, or you say you know some president of some country, but do you know really about that? No, it's just information. Now, how do you get a thorough and intimate knowledge of God? Not from Sunday school textbooks or animated movies. No, all these are good, but we have to read His word, meditate on it, pray and communicate with God, listen to His voice, and have fellowship with other believers. Above all, the Holy Spirit within us will guide us and correct us when we are wrong. So children, ask God for the wisdom to know what is right, what God wants done, and the will to do it. So I'm sure all of you will be really wise in this way. Thank you and God bless you.
Wisdom has built a house. She has hewn out her 7 pillars. She has slaughtered her meat. She has mixed her wine. She has also furnished her table. She has sent out her maid, and she cries out from the highest places of the city. Whoever is simple, let him turn in here. As for him who lacks understanding, she says to him, "Come eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Forsake foolishness and live, and go in the way of understanding."
Whoever correct a mocker invites insult. Whoever rebukes a wicked man inculcates abuse. Do not rebuke a mocker or he will hate you. Rebuke a wise man and he will love you. Instruct a wise man and he will be wiser still. Teach a righteous man and he will add to his learning. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. For through me your days will be many and years will be added to your life. If you are wise, your wisdom will reward you. If you are a mocker, you alone will suffer.
Folly is an unruly woman. She is simple and nothing. She sits at the door of her house on a seat at the highest point of the city, calling out to those who pass by, who goes straight on their way. Let all who are simple come to my house. To those who have no sense, she says, stolen water is sweet, food eaten in secret is delicious. But little do they know, they have debts are there. They are guests are deep in the realm of their debt.